We're going to take a look at grading. The question from 2011, Form B. This was the other version of the test that was given, not the actual like big one that they release on AP Central now. But 2011 B, another good question. It involves a confidence interval. And for part A, it says construct a 99% confidence interval for the proportion. That really gives you a really big hint there. It's going to be a 1 prop Z interval that we're calculating. And we know we have to jump in and check the conditions because there's nothing there that says assume all the conditions are met. So we're going to look at, first of all, is that people have to be independent of each other. Okay. So they say that they're met, and they're explaining since random sampling. Okay, I'm looking for the people are independent of each other. That would be condition number one. It's missing on my particular paper. It does say that random sampling was given. All right, so the problem states that a random sample was taken. That's number two. Number three, I'm looking for the 10% condition. I'm looking over the sample size here that we have 2,350. That certainly is less than 10%. So for part number three right here, the 10% condition is missing. Now I do see the condition for normality, NP and NQ. Now one thing that's wrong there is there needs to be hats on top of these, okay? And that is wrong. They have substituted, they have sort of substituted in. I don't see the substitution that is correctly done. I want to see the formula, substitution, and answer. They do say that they're both above 10, but there's two things wrong. I don't see the entire substitution, and I don't see the right hats. So I'm not going to give credit for condition number four, even though they attempted to do it. It's not close enough. There's still some errors in there. And then I need a since statement that explains that we're doing a 1 proportion Z interval, okay? And I see that right up here, so I am going to give them their fifth check there on this particular part. So, 4 conditions and a since statement, my person got 2 out of those 5. And now we're going to move directly on to the mechanics here. The mechanics are going to do totally on the calculator since we named the test. And what I'm looking for in the mechanics is two things, all right? The p hat is equal to 0.41617. You can do a direct copy off of the calculator. But then there also has to be the interval. The low end is about 0.38998, close enough here. The high end is 0.442 something. The high end, they have that one correct. So for their mechanics, they have 2 out of the 3 check marks for the mechanics part. Remember, the safest thing to do is state the name of the test and do a direct copy off of your calculator. Now, the question here says construct an interval and then use the interval to comment on the belief that 45% have received the flu vaccine. So it does not say to interpret the interval. So that means I'm not looking for, I am 99% confident that the true population proportion of vaccine eligible people who have received the flu vaccine is between those two numbers, all right? I hope that you wrote it down though, all right? But it didn't ask for it, all right? No matter what, when you have an interval, interpret your interval just in case. In this case, they didn't look for it. They do want you to comment on that whole 45% thing. Now, if you look at the interval, okay, look carefully, where does 45% fall? It is not inside. So that means your answer has to have that it's not plausible, okay? Let's see. So here down here, it says 45% is not contained in the interval, so it is not plausible that they received it, okay, that it's not 45%. So I see that. I see that they have it's not contained in the interval. Check. All right. And there's one more check I'm looking for. Is there context? Yeah, they talked a whole lot about vaccines and stuff like that. So my person did get 3 out of 3 for that particular part for part A. Okay. So now moving quickly on to B. And B says, suppose a similar survey was done in Canada, completely different sort of place. They want to calculate a confidence interval, but they're asking for what is the smallest sample size that can be used to guarantee that the margin of error will be less than or equal to 2%. This one is a sample size problem, okay? And that means you're trying to find out what N is, all right? So this person actually showed some pretty nice work, but remember, we know that ME, the margin of error, is equal to Z star times SE, and for a proportion, it's gonna be P hat Q hat over N, all right? So unfortunately, that's not gonna give you any credit, but work gives you credit. You're gonna have to show substitution into the formula. Now, our margin of error they want us to use is 0.02, 2%. Z star, all right? So you already actually might have already done it from the previous part, but remember the Z star that we're looking for here for 99% confidence, okay? This would be negative Z star and this would be positive Z star. So Z star would be equal to the inverse norm, okay? So if that's 99%, 1% is shared, so this is half a percent. This is also half a percent. So what I'm gonna do is inverse norm 0.995, and that's gonna give me 2.576. So that's what I'm gonna plug in to Z star, all right? Now, N is what we're trying to find. P hat and Q hat, we don't know. We're gonna use 0.5 and 0.5, and we want the margin of error to be less than or equal to that. So I'm gonna go ahead and put an inequality there. Now you don't have to technically have it. When you restate your answer in words, you can address that sample size or higher, or at least that sample size will give you that margin of error. So in terms of check marks at this point, all right, what I'm looking for is did you set it up correctly, okay? So I'm looking for do you have the right Z star, okay? And do you have the 0.02 and the 0.5.5? That is the second check in the setup, all right? Now, using your calculator and algebra magic, okay, you're gonna find out that N, okay, is equal to 4,147 point something. And it doesn't matter what the something is, what you're always gonna do on sample size is round up. So our answer is gonna be 4,148. So if you got that answer, give yourself a check. If you didn't round up, don't give yourself a check, okay? But then there's one more thing that we're gonna have to do, all right? We're gonna have to make sure we say it's that number or higher, or at least 4,148 Canadians, okay? All right, so, and they say at least right here, okay? Because that's the only way that the margin of error can be 0.02 or less. The bigger the sample size, the smaller the margin of error is gonna be, okay? All right, so we have four checks on this particular problem. All right, so my person got all four. All right, so now going back to the total score, 4 plus 3 is 7, 7 plus 3 is 10, 10 plus 5 is equal to 15. There are 15 points right here, 3, 4. My person missed 4, so they got 11 out of 15, and that marks the end of the grading of this question from 2011B. Bye-bye.